हेलो वेलकम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। मैं हूं तस्खीर। इस वीडियो में हम देख रहे हैं 11 सरप्राइजिंग फैक्ट्स अबाउट द ISI इंटर सर्विस इंटेलिजेंस। हम FTD फैक्ट्स देखेंगे कि सरप्राइजिंग है या नहीं मेरे लिए, ये देखते हैं।
The Inter-Service Intelligence, also known as the ISI for short, was formed on January 1, 1948. The agency is made up of military officers and personnel from Pakistan's armed forces.
Pakistan's powerful intelligence agency ISI is among the most active intelligence enterprise and covered direct action forces in the world.
It is part of the Pakistani army, but it operates generally beyond the control of the Pakistani government as a whole.
Thanks for joining me here on another episode of FTD Facts. I'm Leroy Kenton, and now by far this past week, this was the most requested topic. I mean, like, everybody wants to know about the ISI. Mustanir Ahmed requested it, Zuhaib Mohammed as well, Salman Saeed, and then we have Khalid al-Baloshi, and then we have Minhal Salim, and not to mention a bunch of other people. So let's begin with the facts. The American Prime News declared Pakistan's inter-service intelligence to be the world's best and strongest intelligence agency back in 2011. The ISI headquarters is located in Islamabad, Pakistan, and its main focus is to protect Pakistan's national interests, as well as look into matters of political and social interest to Pakistan and advise the military in the best steps to take. Now, over the years, the ISI has stopped many terror-related attacks well before they were even executed. The ISI is also the largest intelligence agency in the world. The ISI has close to 10,000 agents in the field worldwide. Ironically, it's one of the least funded agencies in the world. It's above all laws in its home country of Pakistan, and it's often referred to as a state within a state because its policies are made outside of all the other institutions with the exception of the army. Now, I want to talk a little bit about Operation Cyclone. If you're not familiar, it was a code name given to an operation between the American CIA and the Pakistani ISI beginning in 1979 and ending in 1989.
But that was the US plan, a trap, codenamed Operation Cyclone, funded by the CIA and designed to draw the USSR into an expensive and distracting Vietnam-like war.
Now, the objective of this mission was to stop the invasion of the USSR forces into Afghanistan by providing support to the Mujahideen fighters in Afghanistan. Now, it was one of the most expensive CIA operations that it has ever undertaken, and it cost them roughly $20 to $30 million US every single year, but that was up until 1980, and by the time they reached 1987, it rose to $630 million a year. It's also reported that no ISI agent has ever been caught or turned. Although this has never been verified, the Pakistani government has not yet taken responsibility for any alleged undercover agent that was caught on foreign soil. There are stories of officials like squadron leader Khalid Khwaja that were arrested on Pakistani soil for conspiracy against the state, but it seems like the ISI has been very good at insulating themselves from any direct involvement in any of the covert operations that they have supposedly orchestrated. If this is true, that's very impressive. The ISI have also played very crucial roles in arresting members of Al-Qaeda as well as the Taliban. Even though most Western TV shows and movies show the ISI in some kind of negative light, where they're possibly shown collaborating with terrorists, the ISI actually have worked very close with the CIA in bringing down crucial targets and officials of the Taliban and the Al-Qaeda all across the world.
ISI is a very professional organization in my experience over the years. I have a lot of respect for them. And I also think it's only in Western minds, and in especially American minds, that you can expect an intelligence service of a foreign country to do something counter to its own interests, to its country's interests.
While there are sources that link ongoing relations between the terrorist organizations and the ISI, the Pakistani intelligence service has played a very crucial role in the capture of very prominent agitators like Ramzi Youssef, Abdul Ghani Baradar, Ahmed Omar, Saeed Sheikh, and many more.
Okay, just
Pakistani security forces captured one of Osama bin Laden's chief lieutenants, Abu Zubaydah, along with 19 other Al-Qaeda operatives in the eastern Pakistani city of Faisalabad. The ISI arrested September 11 mastermind Khalid Sheikh Mohammed. Going further, the ISI and the Pakistani military have worked effectively with the United States to continue pursuing the remnants of Al-Qaeda, and following 9/11, Pakistan stationed 80,000 troops in the troubled province of Waziristan, near the Afghan border in order to help break the back of the Al-Qaeda network.
Now, as I mentioned earlier in this episode, that the ISI have close to 10,000 members. And I say that because the official number hasn't been confirmed. But what is known about the ISI is that they do recruit from Pakistan's military, as well as they recruit civilians and put them through a lot of rigorous training. The training seems to be very secretive because there's very little information and details about it. But what we do know is that the agents are trained in covert intelligence gathering and counterintelligence. Again, I mentioned that the headquarters of the ISI is located in Islamabad, Pakistan, and the complex consists of various low-rising buildings separated by lawns and fountains. Declan Walsh, a journalist at The Guardian, he says that the entrance is suitably discreet, no sign, just a plainclothes officer packing a pistol. Walsh also said that the complex resembles a well-funded private university and that the buildings are neatly tended. Moving on now to Operation Tupac. Yeah, you heard that correctly, but it has nothing to do with the American rapper.
June 16, 1971. Mama gave birth to a hell-raising heavenly son.
Operation Tupac was the name of a three-part operation that was designed to secretly support the militants of Kashmir. It was partly started by Pakistan's president Zia-ul-Haq back in 1988, and the name comes from Tupac Amuru II, which is the 18th century prince who led the War of Liberation in Peru against the Spanish rule. The ISI is currently engaged in covertly supporting the Kashmiri militants in their fight against the Indian authorities in Kashmir. This is because the militants in Kashmir are fighting to be independent from India and become part of Pakistan.
Of course, for Pakistan, the overwhelming obsession is India.
Another thing I want to highlight is the Kargil War. The Kargil War was back in 1999. The line of control between India and Pakistan is probably one of the most inhospitable places in the world. There's an unwritten agreement that during the winter, neither force will occupy the border's posts. The ISI broke this agreement in the winter of 1998 to 1999, which led to the Kargil War in the following summer. Although Pakistan is considered to have lost this war, the war is also considered a victory for the ISI, as it caught RAW, its Indian counterpart, completely off guard. India had no clue about the infiltration until they were informed about an unknown strangers occupying Indian posts. Now we're coming down close to the end. Let's talk about Mullah Muhammad Umar Mujahid. He was a top Taliban leader, and it's an open secret now that he was trained by the ISI. A captured Taliban spokesman by the name of Muhammad Hanif told the Afghan authorities back in January of 2007 that Omar was protected by the ISI in the city of Quetta in Pakistan. By November of 2009, the Washington Times were claiming that Omar had been helped by the ISI and that he was now in Karachi. It was only in January of 2010 that Amir Sultan Tarar, who was a retired official and ISI agent, said that Omar was ready to break with his Al-Qaeda allies and make peace with Afghanistan. And finally, let's talk about nuclear tests. Although it's never been proven for sure, but it's said that the Indian RAW, as well as the Israeli Mossad, flew over Pakistan's nuclear test facilities in order to gather information, but they were unable to do that because the ISI planned to keep its nuclear facilities secret and even changed the location of its test sites multiple times to keep away anybody from seeing anything. They finally settled in the Pakistani city of Chagi and ensured the security of the nuclear equipment by guarding the transport plane with six F-16 fighter jets. So it's unclear what sort of nuclear tests have been going on, but that's just how the ISI rolls. People don't necessarily know exactly what they're up to. Now that concludes this episode about the ISI. Thank you guys so much for bringing it to my attention. I learned a lot during this video.
The largest intelligence agency in the world, 10,000 se zyada ya fir 10,000 ke aas paas kuch members hain, and bahut hi interesting cheeze में जानने को मिली, कुछ वॉर्स के बारे में, कुछ वहां पर इस्लामाबाद में उनका जो मेन ऑफिस है उसके बारे में, सीक्रेट्स को सीक्रेट्स रखना जानती है आईएसआई, एंड बहुत सारे जो न्यूक्लियर उनके जो टेस्ट वगैरह चलते रहते हैं उनके बारे में भी लोगों को ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं पता करने को मिलता, मतलब ज़्यादा नहीं जान पाते, तो वो सीक्रेट्स रखने में भी माहिर हैं। जब इतना ज़्यादा फंड नहीं मिलते हुए भी नंबर वन पर है, कभी कोई आईएसआई एजेंट पकड़ा नहीं गया कहीं पर, तो ये भी एक अचीवमेंट है, बहुत बड़ा अचीवमेंट है। एंड करगिल के बारे में भी हमें पता चला, इसमें बहुत कुछ जानने को मिला। बहुत लंबी लड़ाई, बहुत लंबे टाइम से वॉर चल रहा था, एंड उसका जो इसमें वीडियो में हमें पता चला कि क्या था, क्या नहीं था, क्या हुआ था। एंड काफ़ी कुछ शॉकिंग था, काफ़ी कुछ इंटरेस्टिंग था, वीडियो था काफ़ी ज़्यादा ऑसम। कॉमेंट कर बताइए आपको कैसा लगा ये मेरे साथ वीडियो देखकर। अगर अच्छा लगा तो लाइक करके शेयर कर दो, चैनल पर नए हो तो सब्सक्राइब कर बेल आइकन प्रेस कर लो। मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट वीडियो में, तब तक के लिए अपना ख्याल रखो। बाय बाय, टेक केयर, साइनिंग ऑफ।